said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the defense. Infused versus Mousesports, the last game for Infused in their group stage to see if they get to go 3-2 or is it going to be 2-3. Currently locked up at 2 apiece for them, wins and losses. Let's see how they're going to go, but Mousesports, a formidable opponent, an aggressive opponent. Will they test Infused? Will they push them to the max? I definitely hope so. Let's jump ourselves inside the game where the draft has already begun, and I can introduce you my co-commentator. A lot of people might know her from her days. A couple of them trying to get SK Gaming off again after they changed to whatever freaking name they went to and then disbanded. Her name is Siri. The world should know her. She also did the Celebrity Community Challenge for the guys out there who watched that one, as well as the girls. But yeah, she will now be my co-commentator for this game. Welcome, Siri, back to the broadcast.
Hi, Toby. Thank you so much. And good morning and hello to all the Americans and good afternoon to all the Europeans.
It's well done, and it's a good evening or good middle of the night to all the guys.
Let's hope you can't have everything. Nice.
I can't. Yeah, I was thinking there's a demographic being missed right there. Have to be on top of it. Yeah, but we get to have Mouse versus Infuse, so I'm interested to see how this one's going to roll out because Infuse doing their thing with the draft, which they did last night, and it's putting Beastmaster, putting Lashrak into that ban pool just so they can get they try and get Lycan out. They try and get The PA is what they used yesterday. They just keep on pushing through all of these big heroes that everybody wants.
Yeah, I like the fact that they're very inventive. They don't really stick to the same 10 to 15 European heroes that you always see banned. It's actually pretty interesting that they banned Darkseer. I remember back in the early beta, Darkseer before the nerf was just incredible. They pick up Vino first, so that's... very, very different. You don't really see that too much, especially in the Euro scene. So it's interesting to see what they're going to do here.
Why are they banning that out? Why are they picking him out? Like, Darkseer ban, that's actually fair enough. Everyone, we know just how much problems he is when it comes to team fights. Mousesports go with Broodmother SK. So we've got quick side lane push. We've got good team fight again from them. And they've already moved out Chen and Prophet, which is going to be two big thorns in the side. But the Venomancer first pick is so unusual, and then follows up with Tide and CM. CK is going to be completely ignored during this game. Brewmaster's being ignored as well. We've got Invoker, who hasn't even been looked at. There's just so many of these heroes. Shadow Demon's not even selected. They're going to go Tide, the CM, so Tide's the counter to the Broodmother. And then Enigma from Mousesports. Okay, let's just go into whatever's aggressive in the mid-game.
I thought that we would see an Enigma come out as soon as they picked the Brood. Right now, Enigma Brood is really prevalent in the European scene. And they probably took the SK first with the Brood to make sure that Infuse did not take the SK. It's interesting, though, to see what Infuse is doing. They're definitely keeping their options open. They're not really locked down to anything right now because there's very little that Tide does not work with, same with CM, same with Vino. Right now, they have the ability to stop pushes. It's very hard to push up choke points with Ravage and Mass Wall with Vino Wards, and they also have a little bit of push with Vino Wards, so it'll be interesting to see what they go for here. Whereas Mouse's lineup is pretty solid. You know that you're going to be seeing a Brood as a solo. You know Nygma's either going to be in the jungle or be soloing mid. So, you know, they're kind of a little bit locked down, whereas Infuse just has a lot of flexibility right now. Their last two picks, you know, they can do almost anything with.
Well, that is true, but they took a bit of a gamble to go through this last banning stage and maybe not get the heroes they're looking for, but Mousesports just think, you know what, Infuse are going to go the normal strat. That's what they're thinking, banning out the Void and the Spectre in the last set. Just thinking, Infuse, it's all distraction. The whole thing is just distraction. And Infuse removing out Lich as well as AM, which is, it's a semi-combo that Mouse have used, but I don't know if they'll really want to go down those lines in this game when you got an Enigma, a Brood, and an SK. It's more they want to be aggressive with these three heroes, and it's Mousesports' playstyle. They love to be on the front foot. They like to be, like, sticking it to the man.
Definitely. And I think that, especially in a game where you have a Brood, where all of your team fights until very, very late are going to be 4v5, you don't really pick a hero like Anti-Mage that needs, you know, to have some time alone to split push and farm up, etc. So, but I think the Lich ban was really great, considering that they already picked up that Enigma, and you really don't want to give any any map control to a team that early. It's half the, think about it, if Enigma and Lich are in one lane, that's already half experience for whoever's going. So that's a good ban for them. Mouse picks up Shadow Demon, very, very strong hero. At the moment, you know, I think that Infused might have the problem that they don't have a whole lot to stop Black Hole. I mean, they obviously have Ravage, but besides that, you know, the range on Frostbite is rather small, so is Shuriken. So they're going to have some problems unless they pick something up with a little bit more control and more range here for the Black Hole.
Well, they might be fighting someone in a second. You could, well, actually, the toss range is not too shabby, but you are right. It's just to interrupt it, and Juggernaut's going to be the last pick up by Infuse. So Wagamama getting his CM Jugger lane, which he enjoys. It's also CM Jugger Venomancer. It's going to be a very, very high protected lane, which we kind of assume to be on the bottom lane if they want to go aggressive with that. And that'll leave either Bounty Hunter or Tide to do that other thing. And Mouseball's going with the Kunkka. They just finished destroying Moscow 5 with their Kunkka play recently. And as far as control goes, Mouseball's now going through the roof. We got X Mark Spot, we've got Disruption, we've got Enigma Stuns and Black Hole, we've got SK with his Burrow Strike, and then the ship from Kunkka. This is going to hurt Infused if they get any hero called out of position.
It definitely is, and I think a lot of people underestimate how viable the boat is right now, just because it's 50%, or I'm sorry, it's 100% damage reduction for a certain amount of time. I don't know. I just woke up. Sorry.
Don't worry. My Dota 2 just crashed, so I will be relaunching back in a couple of seconds.
Oh, actually, you know, I think mine crashed too. It might have been global crash. Is yours stuck at 41 seconds?
My one is stuck at 41 seconds. I think the entire Dota 2 just crashed.
Oh. All right. Well, there you go. But Infuse just has so much burst damage, you know. They have the Ravage, they have Bounty Hunter, which is obviously a burst damage hero, and they have Jug, which is going to do a lot of damage in a short period of time. Omnislash doesn't last too long until you pick up 11 and 16. So until that time, you know, they have a lot of damage mitigation from that Kunkka boat if he manages to get the rum on everyone. And, of course, Shadow Demon Kunkka is a great lane. It's actually one of the best lanes as far as being able to kill a solo hero. It's very, very, very difficult to get away from that. A lot of Kunkkas do decide to bypass Tidebringer and get a couple of levels of early X because, you know, you put someone under, throw up the torrent, then they come out of the torrent, they're slowed, and they have the illusions hitting them, and then they can be X'd back as well, so even blinkers have a problem with this. Here, like Potom, not so much, because she has Leap, which is not, which doesn't really have a cast animation, but a hero like Quap, almost 9 times out of 10, players on even footing can kill a Quap with that combo.
Just to add insult to injury, I just managed to launch my Dota 2 back up again. Looks like actually, the teams managed to pause it in time. Yeah, the teams have paused it in time, so all we've got to do is just shut down your Dota 2, reconnect it back in again, and then you should be good to go. It looks like some of the players have moved out just a little bit here from Mouse Sports. Great, fantastic. So for some parts of Europe, we all got shut down for that. As well as by the sounds of it, one part of America. Siri back into the game now. But on the bright side, one player must have remained, so everything was fine on that end. They were able to pause it. Sorry, Siri. Every time.
Oh, it's no problem. Just trying to let you know.
Every time I reboot Dota 2, this little thing happens, so it should now be a...
Oh, yeah. It's good
Yeah,
now.
It should be a crap ton better for you now.
Yeah. I was just like, oh my, what is this? I'm not sure if your cast stopped. I don't actually have it open.
Oh, no. The stream stayed up. The live stream's fine. It's just Dota 2, which crashed. I don't know if you also noticed, too, there's no trees on the map.
Yeah.
I don't know if this is just a pause or if, like, Greenpeace just gave up their efforts.
I know that in Dota 1, the trees respawned every 5 minutes, but I don't think it works like that here. I think it's like 5 minutes from whenever they're cut down, so maybe 4 minutes we'll see them pop up. Otherwise, maybe zero. Or, you know, standard to Dota 2 beta. Maybe not at all.
All right, so we just let the guy start again and resume. Yeah, the trees return. Fantastic, absolutely fantastic. Never feels good when there's a naked map, and we'll give some volume back into the game as well. So let's run through very, very quickly who's got what. I'm going to run through the Mouse Force boys very, very quickly, and you can have the Swedish kids all to yourself. We're going to have Sexy Bamboo tanked up a Sab Bamboo heading up towards the top lane as the Broodmother. We've got Come With Me, he's just going to grab one creep and then go Jungle as the Enigma. Then 1437, he will be roaming around a little bit. He's just going warding as a Shadow Demon in towards that middle lane. Will be Sing Sing going solo mid Kunkka. First level Torrent for him, and that leads Black playing as the hard carry SK. I say hard carry, I say semi-carry, farmed up SK. He'll be on the bottom lane.
I think that we are going to see, as soon as Mouseforce goes ahead and sees it, it's, you know, a tri-lane bottom. I think that 1437 is going to transition middle. Kunkka works really well with Shadow Demon, as we said before, and there's just very little he can do to, you know, keep that SK alive. SK's probably just going to have to stay back and use Sandstorm to his advantage. And it looks like 1437 might be in some trouble here, depending on which route.
He's got that wall that's watching it. If the Gale hits, he's still got Disruption, which can screw around with Mini Boy. And he does have that double damage as well. So he's going to be careful right now. Actually, he's really, really low after CM came in. There's the Disruption. Support won't get there in time. And Wyga starts to spin off. Even Bounty Hunter comes in close. But you are right. 1437. A little bit overextension just to deny that bottom rune.
Yeah, I'm not really sure why he chose to disrupt himself. Just because, you know, at that point, he gave the time to the Jug to get in range to get, you know, experience and the kill, obviously, whereas before it would have definitely gone to either the CM or the Vino. So that, I think, was just a tiny bit of a misplay on his part. We are going to see the Shadow Demon Kunkka lane, which is so much fun to watch and competitive. It's just, you know, very high paced and very fun. And it looks like they transitioned their tri-lane middle. So we're going to see a solo versus solo on both lanes. It's going to be a little bit difficult for the Bounty Hunter, I think, just because Black did pick up Caustic.
Oh man, you're gonna watch for Sing here in the middle lane. Disruption will go out right now on the Juggernaut as, Dota 2 just did it again for me.
Yeah, me too. I think spectators aren't gonna have a great time this game.
Yes, at this point, we start just sending a message to Valve. We're going to be back in a moment, guys, until we can sort out what the hell's going on. So stick around. We shall return soon, hopefully, with a game which doesn't crash. Back in a sec.